Hey everyone, it's Darren Pfeiffer, and this is Bridge the Atlantic.
Hey, how's everyone doing? From Bridge the Atlantic, I'm singer-songwriter Marcin Valley from Canada.
And I'm music web designer Ross Barber-Smith from Scotland.
And you're watching Encore, a show featuring advice for musicians from the industry's finest. If you're new here, subscribe.
Today we're joined by Darren Pfeiffer from Los Angeles. Darren is best known as the drummer of platinum-selling pop-punk band Goldfinger, but as well as being a musician, he's also an accomplished label owner and radio host.
Darren, can you share some tips with us about contacting labels or management? As a manager or label, what are you looking for in that initial email or submission that will grab your attention? And maybe you can also talk about how frequently an artist can get in touch again and again.
What am I looking for? I have gotten emails, guys, from artists and bands with very elaborate emails, with lots of paragraphs and pictures and flash and links to YouTube and links to the download and links to this and links to their mom's panties. I that's all fine and dandy. But I think the simpler, the better. One or two sentences. Hey, I'm in this band. We're generating some noise. Here's a link to our YouTube video. I'd love for you to check out this just one song. I'm asking for 3 minutes of your time. Thanks. Hope to hear back from you soon. The shorter, the better. You know, there's a saying, keep it simple, stupid. And it's it totally rings true. Keep it simple and just send that email and hope that someone clicks on it. And be diligent, too. Like, if you don't hear back from them, like I mentioned in the past, like, wait a week or two or three and hit them back again. And always be super polite and say, hey, I appreciate your time. I know you're busy. Give it a listen. Keep hammering those phones, keep hammering those emails until you get a response. And if you don't, just maybe after three or four emails, go, look, I know you're busy and I know you got a lot on your plate, but I just would love some honest critique. If it sucks, tell me it sucks. If I'm onto something here, tell me how I can make it better, how I can re-record it and make it better, or how I can going forward song and from a songwriting point of view, how can I shape my songs to be more catchy, to be more hooky? But I always reach out to these bands that I like and say, you're close. You're almost there. Or if the song is bad, I'm not as good as reaching out to them and telling them I'm not interested. Cause if I did that, I'd be telling bands all day long I'm not interested. And a lot of the times I get these videos and these songs and they're recorded very poorly. And they're just absolute garbage. I mean, of course, I'm not going to name any names, but it's just so bad. And it's like you got a long way to go. I should tell them that I how to fix things, but like I just don't have the time. I got Ryan Sims. I got some other bands I want to work with right now that I'm developing. And but yeah, just be overly polite. You know, be Canadian. Be polite, be Canadian, say please and thank you, tell people you appreciate their time. Don't apologize, don't say you're sorry.
Well, we do all the time, though. I'm sorry I'm emailing you, but I'm sorry I'm doing this.
If it sucks,
I'm sorry you're listening to my music right now instead of, having a cup of coffee. That might be the best thing anyone out of our 157 guests we've had on the show. Well, be more Canadian.
I've gotten that's a merch idea if I've ever heard one.
Be more Canadian.
T-shirt says be more Canadian.
I might steal that from you, Darren. That might be my next T-shirt. Be more Canadian. Absolutely. I'll put in quotes, Darren Pfeiffer.
Like it's some. Earth shattering quote, like from Richard Stephen Hawking or something like that.
And I'll have you like this, like all poetically in there and just be like, be more
I'm actually going to do
Canadian.
It. I'm going to make it.
I love it.
And Darren, we'll even give you a cut of the royalties and we'll discuss that in private.
I would love that. That'd be great.
Oh my God.
But again, just to close up your question, yeah. Guys, if you're an artist, really work on your craft. I mean, and you have to be willing to take negative feedback. I've dealt with a few artists in the past that my songs are awesome. Fuck you. Like, well, that attitude is going to take you real far in life.
Yeah.
In my case, I was lucky enough to partner up with a guy named John Feldman and it was able to listen to every time John came to me or the band with a song, it was killer. So I got really, really lucky to find a guy like him. So if you want to be a songwriter, work on your songwriting craft. If you're a bass player or a drummer or a guitar player or a keyboard player and you just want to be in a band and be successful, then go around your town and find the guys that are just murdering it and become friends with them. Say, hey, do you need a bass player? And they'll be like, well, not right now, but if you keep on them, maybe one day they will be need a bass player or a drummer. And next thing you know, you're in that band. The next thing you know, you're signed to Interscope. The next thing you know, you're on the road. It can happen that quickly. But if you're a songwriter, really work on your craft. Sit down with the people that are better than you. Go to songwriting seminars. Go to Canadian Music Week or North by Northeast or South by Southwest or CMJ or Madem and spend the money and go to these songwriting panels and learn what makes a good song. Take a song you admire, like a Beatles song, and rewrite it. Change the chords by a half step or a full step and just rewrite it and see what happens. Cool. There's a million ways to get better at your craft and take it seriously. I do. I'm not the best manager in the world or the best label, but I'm going to these people who are better than me when I go to these seminars and these meetings and I pick their brain. How do you do this? How do you do that? What's the best course of action here? What's the best course of action there? And you just take little baby steps towards becoming a better manager or a better label.
I love that. And if there's no reason why, if you're doing that the artists that you're working with or any other artists shouldn't be doing that. I like that.
Be more Canadian.
Yeah, be more Canadian. That's awesome.
We hope you enjoyed this encore episode. For more from British Atlantic, find us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. And if you want to pick up one of our shirts, visit our website and use coupon code BTARocks and you will receive 20% off your order.
This episode was brought to you by Social Surge, your source for social media marketing and online music promotion. Check them out because they do our us.
They keep this show alive. And if you would like to sponsor the show and become an official Bridger, join us on Patreon from as little as $1 per month. Not only will you be able to showcase your band or brand to our amazing audience, but your support will allow us to keep bringing you weekly videos here at Bridge the Atlantic.